Good morning, students. So in previous class we discussed the topic habitat. So let us continue the same topic, but today is different topic here now. Pond as a habitat in habitat lesson. Here, what is a habitat? Especially, habitat is a dwelling place for animals or organisms which survive in that situation. The habitat provides the optimum conditions for their life. That means habitat provides food, water, shelter and all to the organism. Understood? So now come to the pond as a habitat. So there is several organisms in the pond. To study them more closely, we need to see the different organisms or regions in the pond. So you have to see different regions in the pond where communities of the organisms are present. Which animals and plants do you think would live on the surface of the pond? Which animals and plants do you think would live in the middle of the pond water? Next, which animals and plants do you think would live in the pond margins? Which animals and plants do you think would live at the bottom of the pond? Now I will show you the picture. So in this picture you can see that this is the surface of the pond. Next, this is the surface of the pond. This is the midwater of the pond. And next, this is the bottom of the pond. Margin of the pond means around totally here, this margin of the pond. So you can see that different animals live in different places of the pond. You can see pistia plants on the surface and mid water some fishes, and in the middle water you can see cacti, and you can see different types of plants and animals in the bottom of the water. So like this, different animals live in different places of the pond. In the pond we find that different organisms live in different regions. This is due to some conditions like availability of different amounts of food. So if they need plenty of food, what they eat? Some fishes eat some other small fishes. Some other animals eat dead animals. So those animals eat dead animals that may live at the bottom of the pond. So some animals eat only plant parts. They live on the surface of the pond. So like that, they select the different areas and they survive their life. In the pond, we find that different organisms live in different regions. This is due to some conditions like availability of different amounts of food, air, light, etc. We find organisms like dragonfly, mayfly and kingfisher living above the surface. So we can observe what on the surface, which type of animals you may observe. On the surface of the pond you can observe dragonfly, mayfly. Surface of the pond we observe dragonfly, mayfly, kingfisher, jetting out of the surface of the pond. They get food from the surface of the pond. So they will get the food materials on the surface of the pond. Organisms like a snail, whirling beetle and pond jackal live on the surface. Organisms like surface. The larva of mayfly, dragonfly also live on the surface of the pond. Plants like Pistia float on water. Pistia iconia float on water. Next, on the surface organisms are easily eaten up by other because there is little protection. So on the surface which animals live, they are eaten by other animals because of there is no protection to them. Next, however there is plenty of food and air, and there is this is why fishes usually come to the surface of the pond to feed them. So fishes come to the surface of the pond to eat food materials, feed them. They always come to the surface of the pond to feed themselves by eating different types of organisms which are present on the surface of the pond. Next, great water boatmen, leech and mosquito larva are found in mid water. So in mid water, shark is found there. In mid water, great water boatmen.
Surface of the pond, what animals are there? Dragonfly.
that can float on the water. Piscia have broad leaves that can float on water. But hydrilla plant which can grow in the bottom of the water, in the mid water, so that has the small thin leaves. Try to think and write why such difference may be there. Because of here, the hydrilla plant is present inside the water. So that's why that has the small thin leaves. But the lotus has the big leaves because to float on water. Next, and animals, the plants that we see in water are called aquatic animals. And the animals which we see in water are called what? Aquatic animals. The plants which we see in water are called as aquatic plants. Next, this type of habitat is said to be aquatic habitat. So the animals and plants which are living in water are called as, they have the aquatic habitat. The animals which live in water are called aquatic animals, and plants which live in water are called as aquatic plants. So the habitat is aquatic habitat. There are several aquatic habitats on the earth, from very small ones like water tanks, ponds, different places in the water tank or pond, small garden pools, pools that form after rain, to large ones like salt water lakes, rivers, seas. So different types of water bodies are there, different types of habitats also there. Tree as a habitat. Tree as a habitat means what? Tree also a habitat. Some animals, just like monkeys, lizards, butterflies, some birds, crows, sparrows, some small snakes and some insects live on tree. So that's why tree also a habitat. Your house also a habitat. So like this we can say different types of habitats. Now in the same way, let us study the plant or a tree as a habitat. Birds, monkeys, squirrels, snakes, ants, spiders, caterpillars, moths, bees, wasps, small plants, just like moths, mosquitoes, or some organisms that you may find on the tree. Try to classify them in table 2 based on where you find them. Add some more examples that you know. Now try to explore the types of organisms that you may see living on a tree or even a medium sized plant found in the surroundings. So you can see that here one table. At the base of the tree, which animals live, that you have to write. Next, on the trunk, that also you have to write. Next, between the branches, monkeys and all, right? On a within or here leaves, on or within leaves. So where they present some animals, that you have to write. Insects. Activity. Select a tree or plant in your school. You may work in a group of 4 to 5 students of your class. So this may not possible now. So but we have to just read. Observe the trees that you have selected over a period of time, say a week, by visiting it at least at 2 different times a day. Do this every day. Nearby your house, if there is any tree, once observe. In morning you observe, at night also you observe. Which types of animals are coming near tree? On the tree you are observing, that you note it in your notebook. So then you can understand about the tree as a habitat clearly. Next, let each member of your group note the observations individually, whether they can. So this also once you try to do. Understood? Make a list of the all organisms seen by you on your first visit. Add the names of organisms that you may find in your next visit. Make a rough sketch of the tree in your notebook and mark the places on the tree where you spot these organisms. Take the help of figure 3. This is your homework today. Which is your homework? 58 page number. This one is your homework today. Which is your homework? 58 page number. Note the following there, no? So these 2 are the homework of today's. Okay, today's homework is this.